I have a couple of items I want to discuss with you this morning, or show you. Just a couple that I take out of my cupboard. Two tractors and a couple of trucks. So, firstly, I would like to show you this Bedford. This is a part, I think it's dinky, we will check now underneath, but it's part of a circus set with four horses in, as you can see, and this can flip off, both of them, and you can take the horses out, and let's us see what make it is. It's fairly big. You can see my hand. The truck is longer than my hand. So this is Corgi Toys. I think it's a Bedford TK, what they call it. Okay, and this is the trailer. Okay, let's park it there. Really big. Okay, and next, maybe I can put this mag light on top of it. You can see the more or less the size. Okay, the next one is a very nice truck. It's a Skarmel, and I want you to check the rear axle when it turns. If you turn with your lorry, the rear axles will also turn. That's very nice, just like the real thing. And underneath is just a trolley wagon or a bogey, I'm not sure what you call it. But when your logs is secured on top and you turn, that wheels at the back will also turn. Let's pick it up maybe and give it a test. See if we can see the action better. So this is very, very nice. I bought this truck at the toy fair some point a couple of years ago, that one as well. Okay, and then I've got a very nice Ford D800 tip truck, and this is I believe a dinky as well, dinky Ford D800. There's a price that I paid for it also a couple of years ago, 250 rand, on a toy fair. And I polished this morning the windscreen a little bit. It's very dull, but it looks now great, and it have a crack in. Somebody glued it sometime in the past. And the doors can open. It's a right-hand drive. So this is a very nice truck. I remember it from when I was in grade 2. This was on the market, and so it's very old. It comes from the 70s. very glad to pick that up. Okay, and then I've got another truck. This is EF. Let me just make sure if we can see. It's a EFE. There you can see something. EFE or something. I need tires for it. I put some little tires on that I take off from a modern car or something, just to put something on. It never had tires. I would like to have some rubber for it. There's space for double, dual tires at the rear. It's a mammoth. I can now see ABC or ABC mammoth truck. Die cost. Okay, then I decided to throw in two John Deere's as well. This is a 830 with the propane tank. And I remember that this was very strong tractors. I believe for the time it was something like 80 or 90 horsepower. It sat a long time in one of my cupboards, and the sun take the color away there on that decal. That one is nice and yellow still. Nice fat rear tires on it. Okay, and then at a point somebody was very interested in this tractor. It came out of a previous video that I put on YouTube a long time ago, and recently I had comments from somebody that would like to see it better. I had this also for a long time, many years. This is probably a 2010 or a 1010 or a 1020 or something like that. Maybe a 2030 John Deere, but I don't think, because I see it's a three cylinder, so it's probably something in the 10s, 20s, that kind of ranges. There's little detail there. This is a play model, it's not a exact model. Some detail on it, and it's steerable. Nice toy for a child, but I bought it in this unplayed condition. You can see the tires never see anywhere or play scratches and so on. So it's in a very nice condition. Okay, and the last model is a little cheap Mercedes truck that I have. It's a die-cast body. This is all plastic. I just thought I throw it in. There it is. It's trailer. Plastic, all plastic. Okay, so this is a couple of trucks I have. And I've got many more boxes full. If anybody would like to see any more tractors or trucks, let me know, specific model or name. I've got them all. Okay, gentlemen, thank you very much for watching, and see you on the next one. Cheers.